Agriculture alone constitutes about 80% of the total water withdrawals in India, which is way above the global average. These withdrawals are based on the water requirements of each crop. More specifically, every crop has critical growing stages within which certain amount of water must be irrigated to avoid crop damages. However, water productivity at present is low in India. If you consider rice, which is already a water-intensive crop, it requires about 2,500 liters to produce 1 kg of rice. In reality, we use 3,500 liters or even more to produce the same amount of rice. Farmers are practically sunk. They base their irrigation decisions on the availability of water from major irrigation sources, or if they are self-sufficient, they plan it on a regular basis to avoid crop losses. In either of the cases, the irrigation decisions are not well informed in terms of what is going to be the state of weather in near future, whether there is expected rainfall or is it expected to be cloudy in the next few days, reducing the overall temperature. All this is critical in deciding the daily crop water requirement. In irrigation, there are two terms called blue water and green water. Blue water is the withdrawals from irrigation sources, while green water is the rainwater which is naturally available. If we are able to use the rainwater in crop production, then we can effectively increase the crop water productivity. Presently, there are 7-day weather forecasts available to the farmers from government agencies. These forecasts are mostly qualitative in nature and they cover broader regions, failing to capture the internal variability of rainfall occurrences. Like for example, rainfall varies within few kilometers, which is not actually captured by the forecasts. With this backdrop, the major objective of my research is to formulate methods that generate short-term weather forecasts which are quantitative in nature with a given confidence bands and of high spatial resolution. To put it in simple terms, I'm trying to simulate weather at every 4 km by 4 km cell and say if there is a rainfall event, how much confidence can I have on the occurrence, that way increasing the reliability of the forecast. Another objective is to use the generated weather forecast in a farmer-like crop simulation algorithm to model the irrigation decision and to quantify the impact it has on the existing water productivity. We have selected Tamaravelli Basin, a rice-intensive basin in Tamil Nadu, as the test site. So far, we have effectively tweaked and tuned a weather model by running numerous simulations, about 500 simulations. The results have given positive signals in generating high-resolution ensemble forecast for the region. However, we also face a lot of challenges within a given limited computational framework, how to make the procedure practically feasible and how to increase the repeatability of the procedure for various weather phenomena. At the end of the day, the research is trying to model a real system which has a lot of inherent uncertainty by itself. We definitely believe that at the end of the research, we will be able to effectively address some of those criticalities.